So, hello everyone. This video is all about extracting casein protein from milk. First step, of course, is ensure that your milk is hot. Okay? Prepare that. Formulate that. Timplahin ninyo. Okay? Remove the solid parts or yung mga namuo sa gatas. Okay? So, make sure to thoroughly mix it. Then, remove the solid parts. Then, using a pipette, a syringe, or a medicine dropper, gradually drop vinegar on the milk gradually.
So on your 250 ml of milk, gradually drop 200 ml of vinegar. Do that gradually,
because if you will not, you will be having clumps, large clumps of casein, and that is not a good way to extract that. So you may stir that from time to time, stir that, and then put another vinegar gradually. Then you will notice a formation of white clumps, and that is the casein. So the next thing you need to do is filter that using your cloth on a funnel or in a strainer, and then you have your another container. So you have to filter out the liquid part there and the solid part. So you will have to wait that until it's settled down. So this is now your casein protein, and this casein protein is being used to make plastics and other dairy products. So in this lab activity, you will be doing plastic, or will be making plastic out of that. So to make plastic out of that, you have to mold that in any shape that you want. So you will have to mold that right away. Mold this in any shape that you want. And you may color that after you shape that after it dried. And this is now your extracted casein from milk and plastic.
As always, make a detailed documentation of the step-by-step procedure, either in forms of photos or time-lapse video or any form you want. Take note that your appearance must be seen in each step-by-step procedure. Second, clean your working area before and after the lab activity. Wear decent attire. Answer the following. A. What is casein? Letter B. What are the uses of casein? Letter C. Describe the texture and odor of your extracted casein. Letter D. Narrate your experiences, feelings, insights during the lab activity. 4.1. Submit your answers in form of docs, PDF, or just by typing it directly on my new Messenger account. If you will answer in docs or PDF, submit that through my Gmail account, birdinazaresa@gmail.com. So my new Messenger account is the one that I'm using right now in conversing with you through Messenger group chat. Okay, so that's all for this walkthrough on your asynchronous lab activity.